Shut up and sit down.
My favorite author, Chetan Bhagat, essay. Essay on my favorite author, Chetan Bhagat, for students and children in English. Chetan Bhagat was born on 22nd April 1974 in Delhi. After completing his schooling, he got graduated from the Indian Institute of Technology, IIT, Delhi, and did his master's from IIM, Ahmedabad. After working for 11 years in Hong Kong as an investment banker, he returned to Mumbai and began full-time writing. He had started his novel about life on the campus of an IIT while at work only. After much struggle, his first novel, 5 Point Someone, came in 2004, and this very first project led to an immense rise in his fame. This book continues to be the most landmark book in his literary career, being the highest selling book of India to date. The book also won the Society Young Achievers Award and Publishers Recognition Award. Bhagat had started with a comedy-based novel, writing it in simple English. The author, Samit Basu, puts, "Chetan has shown how wrong Indian publishers are when they explain away their failures to sell Indian fiction to large number of Indians by saying there are no readers. Chetan's managed to tell them they exist. His easy style of writing and the issues linking to everyday problems were well received by readers, particularly the youth. What is evident from Bhagat's first two books, 5 Point Someone and One Night at the Call Center, is that Bhagat construct his narratives around the lives of urbanized youngsters. The pressures to get into a top school, earn high grades, get a good job and find the right partner. In other words, much of his popularity can be attributed to his being able to have created a connection with Indian youth. Bhagat has written 7 books so far, 5 Point Someone, One Night at the Call Center, The 3 Mistakes of My Life, 2 States, Revolution 2020, What Young India Wants, and the latest being Half-Girlfriend. Apart from writing novels, Bhagat also writes for the columns of the Times of India and Dainik Bhaskar, among others. These columns have a focus on youth and national development issues. Chetan's columns are written in a way that directly points out the issues within our country, and many times it has even triggered discussions in the parliament. He is not only a good writer, but also a motivational speaker and has given many motivational speeches on various occasions at various institutes. He has addressed issues like corruption by sending a letter to Sonia Gandhi, and also has spoken about the political issues that revolved around Baba Ramdev. Bhagat's fame cannot be applauded for his writing only. His success has been but a carefully calculated work targeted to capture the mind share of people from all across India. To cater to the mass market, the publisher had carefully played around with the price point. All of Bhagat's novels have been priced at affordable prices, which makes it possible for everybody, especially students, to buy and read. His other marketing strategies include the media buzz. He has his website. His first books contain teaser for the upcoming books. He initiated the concept of selling signed copies at a premium price and sensibly campaigns his book launches by inviting eminent personalities. Bhagat is often credited with revolutionizing the commercial fiction industry in India. Typical Indian bestseller sold between 3,000 and 5,000 copies. But Bhagat's novels, with sales of a staggering million copies a year, sparked off a trend itself. Chetan Bhagat, irrespective of public opinion, continues to be a boon for the publishing industry, for India has never been swept to read like this before. The sales have never been so amazing. His words struck a chord with young India. India that never read Indian writing in fiction. Some of the readers who start with Bhagat's fiction migrate to literary novels with time. New authors following his footsteps are only benefiting out of it. And the same holds for the old authors who could capitalize on the widening market. Even to this day, almost 10 years since his first book appeared in the market, his book occupies prime space in all the bookstalls of even the smallest railway stations. People know that his work is nowhere close to the literary works of Shakespeare. Instead, he writes that appeals to the mass population. Critics argue that his novels lack substance, yet he ignores them, citing he writes stories that people can relate to, and so goes on to come up with something new every time. As a script writer, he has himself written the story of his books into movies, which has proved to be blockbuster hits. In 2010, Time magazine named him as one of the 100 most influential people in the world. He has renewed the definition of talented IIT engineers who were thought to be bookworms, lacking fun in life. Instead, his educational background has boosted his portfolio. Many engineers themselves have turned to write just like him.